Great, thanks, Andrew. You know, that was a pretty cool demo, but actually, I'd like to take that up a notch and show you something that I think is even more impressive. So what I'm going to do now is I'd like to call up Jay and Amanesh from IBM. And what they're going to do is they're going to take the same app that you just saw Andrew write, the same guestbook app, and without modifying a line of code, they're going to deploy that app on-premise to the IBM WebSphere application server that's right on this box here. So guys, have at it.
Thanks, Kevin. Hi, I'm Jay Subramania, and I'm the director for the IBM Cloud Labs team in our software group strategy organization. And as Kevin mentioned, many of our enterprise customers typically want to run their Java code within the corporate firewall. But they all want the flexibility of actually being able to move their applications between different environments so that they get ready for change if they decide to make a change for technical or business reasons. So today, Animesh and I are going to demonstrate how following standard Java APIs and libraries allows our enterprise customers to do precisely that. Now, most of our enterprise customers typically use WebSphere as their application server, DB2 as the database, and Tivoli LDAP to store user information. Now, WebSphere actually is a full J2EE container, but today in our demonstration, we are going to be using it in its most basic form, which is as a servlet container. And there are many servlet containers in the market today. You've seen App Engine, which is an example of another one, and there are others in the marketplace. But what we're going to show you today is how following Java standards allows our users to deploy code in one environment and seamlessly move it to others with making very minimal changes. So I'm going to invite Animesh, my colleague here, to show you this in action. And we're going to demonstrate in the context of the same guestbook application that Andrew showed you and using WebSphere and App Engine as the two servlet containers to do the migration from one to the other. Thanks.
Thanks, Jay. Hello, everybody. My name is Animesh Singh, and I'm the lead architect and developer at IBM Cloud Labs. So as Jay mentioned, when you're building a web application, certain technical features or business rules may require you to move between different environments. But since all these containers and databases can work with standard Java APIs and libraries, redeploying from Google App Engine to WebSphere requires no code changes. Let me show you. So here I have the exact same code which Andrew used to run his guestbook application. What I'm going to do is just make a few config changes. So this is the jdoconfig.xml file. So this information which you have here is specific to Google App Engine, and it's commented out, which just needs to be replaced with this information, which is specific to DB2. And if you see, the information which we are giving to this config file is that this is the connection URL for the DB2. This is the connection driver name, DB2 username, and DB2 password. And that's pretty much what you need to change in the config settings, and then you need to add a few extra jar files, which are basically DB2 driver files, so DB2 JCC jar file and the corresponding license file. And that's it. With that done, I have the exact same application running on this server here, which is running IBM WebSphere and DB2. Let me go to that particular URL. So you see the exact same code, same application which Andrew showed you. And I'll show you that you can do the exact same things. And that's it. With that done, what I have just shown you is that thanks to standard Java APIs and libraries, writing an application which can be moved from Google App Engine to WebSphere is very easy. Finally, my team wanted to make it even easier for App Engine developers to deploy their code to WebSphere. So we have implemented a number of lower level App Engine specific APIs and tools. In fact, starting tomorrow, developers can utilize App Engine's users and data store APIs to interface with Tivoli LDAP and IBM DB2. And it will be available at the following URL. Thanks.